I'm going to demonstrate how to mount the 2-pi cutter router attachment onto your laminate trimming router to use to cut your rosette channels, sound hole, and rosette patch. This attachment will mount on any laminate trimming router. It comes with some protective covering over the clear acrylic. Once you peel it off, this is what you have. There are two types of laminate trimming routers. This is known as an open-based router. Once you take the plastic base off, notice the base of the router has an opening on two sides. This is a closed base router. Once you take the attachment off, there is no opening around the hole. Once you've removed the base, then you want to attach some double stick tape to the plastic base that you've taken off. This will enable you to stick it down to the attachment to drill the holes. Once you've got the tape on, just peel off the backing, and now you're ready to position this on the attachment. Now, you just need to eyeball it into center. It does not have to be exact. Now, I use a backing piece here so that we don't blow out the backside. But you just want to drill through all of these holes. The bottom side that rides up against the piece you're working on is the one with the trench here. So on that face, we're going to countersink these holes so that the screw heads get out of the way and won't scratch your top. Put the screws back in, then you just need to attach the second piece. The second piece mounts on top, the screw up to the bottom, the screw head in the trench, the washer, the wing nut, and finally the pin. The pin rides in the hole in your work board, and the whole assembly rotates on this pin. You need a work board like this. And here's one in progress. Here's the top. We just did this rosette. Here's the pin, which mine is permanently attached to the board, and I don't want to take this off. But this is what's underneath. It's basically a piece of wood with a center line. I have a flat edge on the top. That's for enabling me to drop a perpendicular down here to measure things. And a quarter inch hole for the pin. The attachment fits in this hole like this. And then you can adjust this in and out to make your cuts. If you're going to cut more than one rosette on your work board, you might want to consider using a metal bushing in here. The metal rod will wear the wooden hole out, and what'll happen is you'll get some wobble in there, and that'll translate to an uneven hole. If you first drill this bigger to fit the bushing and then put the metal in the metal bushing, it'll stay tighter longer, and you'll get a lot more use out of it.